One in six couples struggle with infertility. 50% of these couples will find they have a male factor component as part of the big picture. If you've been told you have poor sperm parameters, if you are looking for resources to help you understand more, to learn more, and find ways to treat male factor fertility, look no further. Watch this video. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist, helping people build families for almost 20 years. And I am constantly counseling about male factor fertility. I've got a whole playlist here on YouTube that talks about tips to improve male factor fertility, five things to avoid doing if you want to improve your sperm parameters, also tips on preparing for the semen analysis and how to interpret the semen analysis. Men are 50% of the equation when it comes to having a baby, and so much of the field has been laser focused on women and the people with the ovaries and the uterus. And that is really important, but we cannot forget about the sperm. So male factor fertility is something that is really important to understand, and it can often be confusing. A lot of my patients just say, well, yeah, the doctor said I've got a low sperm count, but I don't know what to do, or the motility is low, and I've been taking supplements, but I don't know if it's helping. And there's a lack of education, a lack of understanding, and just searching on a search engine can really leave you with more questions than answers. So in this video, I want to give you five resources that I recommend to my own patients when they want to learn more, and I want to educate them more about male factor fertility. So let's get started. Resource number one, the American Society of Reproductive Medicine has a wonderful webpage focused on male reproductive health. You can go to this link, and all of these links are going to be in the description, but it basically has multiple articles that are for providers like me and patients, maybe like you, who want to learn more about all these different factors of male reproductive health. And there's excellent information in these practice guidelines and posts that can really help you find more information. Resource number two, Paul Turek and the Turek Clinic blog. So Dr. Turek taught me when I was in residency at UCSF, when I did my fellowship at Stanford. He was still close by and really taught me so much about the importance of male reproductive evaluation and treatment. I've learned so much from Dr. Turek in my career. And he has a wonderful website and an award-winning blog that really goes through and answers so many questions you might have about vasectomies, vasectomy reversals, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, or ICSI, to help with the IVF process. He talks about nutrition. He talks about supplements. So it's an incredible resource. I had the pleasure of interviewing Dr. Turek on my podcast, the Baby Your Best Fertility podcast. We will link the episode here. It was an incredible experience to interview one of my mentors, and you can hear straight from him a lot of the things that he tells his own patients. So again, this resource, Dr. Turek, whether it's his blog or the interview that we did on my podcast, I think you'll find very, very helpful. Resource number three, John and Laura of the Infertility Man. So John and Laura really documented their struggles with fertility on YouTube. That's where I found them. John is very open about his fight with testicular cancer in the past, and when he was ready to have a baby, finding out that he was azoospermic or had no sperm. And they documented their struggles in order to have baby number one and continue to try to add to their family. And they have so much information either on their website at infertilityman.com, their book, which is an excellent resource, and of course their YouTube channel. You can hear directly from them their story. I interviewed them on my Baby Your Best Fertility podcast. I loved talking to them and learning a little bit more about them. They help so much, not only with the knowledge, like I think from the ASRM website and from Dr. Turek's blog, you get a lot of the medical information and kind of pros and cons of different interventions. From Laura and John, you get a lot more of the emotional piece of what it's like to be a man and to be the source of infertility in a couple. There's a lot of tension there. I mean, it's almost expected that if there's a problem getting pregnant, that it's the woman's fault. I mean, that's what we've been taught for centuries. And so hearing, you know, John's side of the story, hearing how supportive Lora is, and what they've gone through as a couple and that emotional piece, I think is really, really helpful for a lot of my patients. So again, check out their website and then also check out the interview that we did together on the Baby or Bust podcast to learn more about their story. Resource number four, Dr. Shanna Swan and her incredible book called Countdown. If you remember the news and the buzz about how sperm counts have dropped 60% across the world within the last few decades, that resource of that studies and that look is really from Dr. Swan. She is an incredible researcher, incredible epidemiologist who shared her own journey and actually initially trying to prove this statistic wrong. And she realized, no, actually, this is true. Sperm counts have dropped worldwide. She answered that question, and then she went on to figure out exactly why. And she has a lot of information, hardcore data, showing that a lot of the things that we're exposed to in our environment, and the air pollution and endocrine disruptors, can really be impacting our sperm function and really changing reproductive health worldwide. She is an incredible resource. That book is eye-opening. And again, I'm so fortunate and grateful to have had her on the Baby Robust Fertility Podcast. You can either read her book, and I'll make sure you have the link here, or you can listen to the interview that we did together and hear directly from her what she was thinking, what she found, and what she thinks that we can do about it for the future. Resource number five, for anyone thinking about using donor sperm for any reason, the Seattle Sperm Bank has an excellent website, a very extensive blog, answering lots of questions like what to look for in a donor, what are all these different labels of vials, how much sperm should you buy, what is this genetic screening for donors? So again, if you want to learn anything about using donated sperm, go to the Seattle Sperm Bank website and blog. It's an incredible resource. And you've heard me probably talk about Seattle Sperm Bank, especially if you've listened to my podcast, because they sponsor a lot of the shows. They did not ask me to include this as a resource. They did not sponsor this YouTube video. I truly think this is an excellent resource, but I do want to clarify that we do work closely together on a lot of different projects, and just make sure I'm open and I disclose that. But really, truly check out that website if you want to learn anything about using donor sperm. So save this video, because these resources are really incredible and they can be used for you and share with friends, anybody that has been diagnosed with male factor fertility. These are excellent resources. So share this video with your friends, save it so that you remember where to find these resources in the future. All of the resources we discussed are going to be linked in the description below. And let's review what we talked about. So if you just want to learn more about male factor, especially the medical side, the research, treatment options, ways to improve with nutrition, exercise, etc., I think the first two resources I gave, the ASRM website and Dr. Paul Turek's blog and his website, are really good for overall understanding of medical research and kind of male factor fertility in general. The third resource, the Infertility Man website and Lora and John, their YouTube channel, their book is so good at some of the medical piece, but they're really best at sharing just what it's like to have male factor fertility, especially from a man's perspective, and just a little bit of more of the emotional piece and kind of dealing with it as a family. Excellent resource. Resource number four, if you want to learn about our environment and how what is in our homes and the products that we use that could be impacting male factor fertility, Dr. Shanna Swan's research and her incredible book, Countdown, is an excellent resource. And finally, number five, if you want to learn anything about using donated sperm, Seattle Sperm Bank website and blog is an excellent resource. I hope you learned something today. Like this video if you learned something, comment with questions that you have. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get your weekly video on reproductive health. And as always, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.